Good day, ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues. Thank you for allowing me to present my research. First of all, I must tell that I'm not a neurologist. I'm not a neurological scientist. I'm an integrative physician who is working in regenerative field of biogerontology. And aging is the leading cause or component of many neurodegenerative diseases. Therefore, patients who suffer or feel that start suffer from neurodegenerative diseases, they often come to me just for kind of rejuvenative treatment, which I do using my technology. What is Alzheimer's disease? You are all aware. And after the brilliant presentation of George, we understand what is the global burden of Alzheimer's disease in the growing population. Just one fact, every 3 seconds somebody on our planet is diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease. And it's only tip of the iceberg. What is Alzheimer's disease? There are different pictures and presentations. I prefer this one, which shows that our brain has some protective mechanisms which protect our neurons and biochemistry of brain from damaging factors. They can be outside factors and from inside, for instance, exogenic factors like smoke, like toxic pollutants, and endogenic factors, which can be chronic infection, neuroinfection, some deficiencies, vitamin and mineral deficiencies, and of course, chronic infection of the brain. And while the healthy brain is relatively good protected against these noxious influences, the brain of people who are falling into neurodegenerative diseases, they are less protective during genetic predisposition and stress factors, and therefore a series of pathogenetic pathomorphological elements develop, like accumulation of plaques and tangles. Background. At present, no pharmacological therapy is in or monomodal treatment was shown to reverse Alzheimer's disease or significantly slow down its progress. On the other hand, a multimodal integrative treatment is found to be promising in prevention, slowing down, and even reversing various forms of dementia. This case report elucidates the efficacy of long-term multiple modality treatment based on the intermittent hypoxic hyperoxic training, the IHHT, on cognitive and executive functions, as well as on general clinical health in 2 women suffering from Alzheimer's disease, Alzheimer's dementia. The first case I published in 2010, when a woman came to my office and for rejuvenative treatment, and then it turned to be that she was in glowing Alzheimer's disease. And after practically 1 year of intensive treatment, she recovered. Background for this, there are already some ideas and research which shows that with applying intermittent oxygen restriction or intermittent oxygen control, intermittent controlled oxygenation, we can influence regenerative processes in our cells, not only in the brain, but in all our cells, because all our cells contain mitochondria. And mitochondrial decline is one of the basic components of aging and age-related diseases and neurodegenerative diseases. Therefore, when I was lucky enough to get the other patient, I started the same program, and now I can summarize the results of treatment for these two patients. The one was a lady born in 1931, and the other is a lady born in 1961. The first one presented in February 2008 with mental deterioration, and and memory loss for about 1 year. Low energy, low quality sleep, loss of interest and motivations, and inability to conduct usual activities and home chores. She didn't take any medications. The other lady, pediatric physician, presented in January 2018 with a attention deficit, depression, irritability, forgetfulness, low quality sleep, often misplaced items. For about 2 years, declining professional skills, emotional instability, depression, verbal deficiency during stress. The only medication was donepezil, 5 milligrams. The cognitive assessment was done using mini mental state examination with a maximum score of 30 points, block drawing test, then pentagram drawing test, and quality of life in Alzheimer's patient test. Before starting treatment, the patient one showed the values which are typical for middle development of Alzheimer's disease, and the second patient so had also similar values. Important that magnetic resonance imaging in both ladies showed degradation, showed dystrophy of cortex, and especially in the second patient, number two, it was hypometabolic changes and external and internal hydrocephalus. Intervention, the basic intervention was integrative treatment with intermittent hypoxic hyperoxic training. How does it look? Patient is lying down in a reclined position, comfortable position, and breathing through the face mask, the air which is intermittently enriched with oxygen and oxygen depleted. And this causes in the body, in our circulatory system and in the cells and in mitochondria, it causes oscillations of oxygen, which are known to stimulate mitochondrial biogenesis and mitochondrial rejuvenation. This is pretty complex, complicated mechanism. I cannot go in details now, but there are lots of corresponding publication. What do we see on the screen? What do we see on the screen of the device? We can see here the green line. This is oscillations of oxygen. Oscillations of oxygen in our blood. So by pulse oximetry we can measure it. The red line is the heart rhythm variation. And the blue line, this is the actual concentration of oxygen. The yellow line, reflects changing of capillary tones. And on the right side, we see correlation with the electroencephalogram, with the frontal lobes. You see the quite certain correlation of hypoxic and hyperoxic episodes with the spectrum of electroencephalographic variations. The other possibility, when the patients already have adaptation to hypoxia, we can do this under physical load. Patients can work on stationary bike, and we can give them appropriate load measuring simultaneously the same parameters. After treatment, after 12 months of treatment with this program, the patient number one undergone also the same tests. She was contact meaningful oriented, no notable verbal deficiency, and improvement on all scores in the cognitive tests. Most important that when a second MRI was done, the neurologist in charge didn't notice any changes in her brain that are more than normal for her age. So it means there was element of morphological recovery of the brain. The patient number two improved also cognitive scores, but her brain didn't change morphologically. Also, all the other values, your behavioral values and quality of life significantly improved. So I just presented this in a table, patient number one and patient number two. Of course, we cannot say here about statistic, we can say that's not enough experience, you need more. Of course, we need more research, therefore I'm presenting it here. Discussion, we can explain now mechanisms that underline these improvements. First of all, this treatment is related to physical exercising, because during physical exercising we also experience oxygen oscillations in our body, in our muscles and in our brain. But this technology makes much more intensive oxygen oscillations. You cannot achieve it with any type of exercise. Moreover, because patients in a progredient dementia, they are not inclined to exercise. They have problems with movement at all, as Professor Ramsey already explained. And therefore, possibility to introduce exercising without exercise has very great value. We have now mechanisms analyzed which underlie this process, the process of adaptation to hypoxia. These mechanisms are the same which we see in hypoxia and reoxygenation, which is normally is interpreted as pathological state. But here it is not pathological, it is precisely dosed, it's precisely controlled, and therefore it produces systemic rejuvenation through the action of nitrous oxide on receptors which provide communication with genome, with nucleus, and provide synthesis of proper pathways which improve oxygen absorption, oxygen transportation, and oxygen utilization. Important is that this method also stimulates our lymphatic system, our internal brain's own system for drainage of metabolites, because our brain is constantly working in kind of deficiency of lymphatic system. So it's not enough evacuation of metabolites. And that is one of the predispositions for accumulation of amyloid and toxins and metabolic decline. Using this method, we naturally stimulate functioning of lymphatic system, so we provide better evacuation of metabolites. Biochemical analysis shows that adaptation to intermittent hypoxia significantly increases mitochondrial biogenesis, mitochondrial activity, mitochondrial biochemistry, improves pH regulation, acid phase status, and increases synthesis of endogenous antioxidative enzymes. you see all these values are significantly increased after hypoxic adaptation. The mechanisms of intermittent hypoxia are researched recently in very many scientific publications. For instance, one of the latest, you see intermittent hypoxia and experimental Parkinson's disease. Protective effects of adaptation to hypoxia and experimental Alzheimer's disease. Neuroprotective mechanisms of intermittent hypoxia. Hyperbaric hypoxia is used until now, in the preparation of pilots and astronauts. Intermittent hypoxia also improves fertility both in women and men. And there are prominent ergotropic effects of intermittent hypoxia. And here is also my publication about intermittent hypoxia in the evolution of mitochondria. One of the latest publications was devoted to intermittent hypoxic hyperoxic training in cognitive functioning of geriatric patients. This is the article from 2017. And it was done in Germany in a large population of patients and over 75. And the authors come to conclusion that IHT turned to be easily applicable and well tolerated by geriatric patients up to 92 years. By the way, my oldest patient at the moment, he is exactly 92. And he is very well, because he continues this method for about 9 years. This method contributed significantly to improvements in cognitive function and functional exercise capacity, also very important in geriatric patients performing multi-component treatments. So, we see that cognitive, executive, and neurological and general clinical benefits of long-term IHT in Alzheimer's type dementia patient without negative side effects were demonstrated. And most important, that improvements are permanent, providing a home-based treatment is continued. So patients, when they can afford this, they just have their machine at home and they use it continuously on regular basis, so about 3 to 4 times a week. These promising results must be confirmed in randomized clinical trials. Thank you very much. Please ask your questions. By the way, any one of you who feels really bad, exhausted, tired before meal, before lunch, can try our method here on the sofa, on the couch, and then share the experience.